Welcome to Love Futsal. How are you keeping? Today we're going to be looking at a pre-match warm-up routine. Now this is specifically designed for those that are alone, that they don't have anyone to warm up with. I play a lot of futsal and I'm quite often the only keeper here. So our warm-up routine is much different to the outfield players. So I'm going to go over a little routine that you can use at home to get yourself ready and fit and warm so you're able to make match-winning saves.
Starting off with a gentle jog, nothing too fast nor strenuous. Dynamic stretches are important as we move through a controlled range of motion, simulating what you'll experience in a game. With the knees up, bring your knees up to around waist height so your thighs are parallel to the floor. This engages and helps strengthen the inner thigh and also the outer hip areas. It also strengthens along the standing leg, toning your calf, quadriceps, hamstrings, and buttock muscles. Heel flicks wake up the hamstrings and activate the muscles supporting the knees. These dynamic stretches all reduce the chance of injury and help improve your performance. It also primes the nervous system, increasing the circulation to the joints and muscles.
Closing the gate, it targets the inner and outer thigh muscles. This also helps strengthen your core and glutes. This exercise also enhances your balance and stability and warms up the hip flexors and groin area. The forward leg swing is great for stretching the hamstrings and hip flexors.
And finish off with the reverse kicks, which work on a huge range of muscle groups and also help with your balance.
You can also add lunges to this rotation and to the dynamic stretches routine that you do, as this also engages the quads and is really relevant to the motions that you will make when performing a block save and as a futsal goalkeeper.
Also guys, remember to stay hydrated. You expend a lot of energy and a lot of sweat and a lot of water, and actually hydration is key to keep the mind working and keep yourself sharp. Next, we're going to be looking at some stretches that you can do before a game. Now, stretching for a goalkeeper is really, really important for a few reasons. It will get you warm and ready so you're able to reach that little bit further and comfortably make saves. But most importantly, it will help protect your body against injuries. If you all of a sudden launch yourself into a split save cold, there's a high chance that you'll do some damage to your muscles. Therefore, get them ready, warm up properly, and then you can keep without any limitations whatsoever.
So I always like to take my time during stretching. It's part of the routine I have before building a game. It's almost mental as much as it is physical. Start by having your legs wider than shoulder width apart and pull your chest in towards your legs. Don't worry about your head so much. I see loads of people trying to get their head against their knee. The important thing is you bring your chest towards your knee and that will give you a much deeper stretch. You'll feel this all along the back of your legs. Whenever changing positions, do so slowly and methodically just to ensure that you don't surprise your body or potentially do some damage. When touching your toes, keep your knees straight and your legs straight, and again, bring your chest into your knees. Don't worry about touching the floor or touching your toes. It depends on your level of suppleness. This will develop over time. If you continually do this warm-up, you'll find yourself being able to reach further and further down over time. With this stretch, put one knee on the ground, and then bring your elbow and try and touch the floor. This opens up your inner hips and inside leg. Then put the leg out to the side and stretch down. If you push your bum into the ground, it really, really stretches this leg. This is a really important stretch to be doing because it's very close to mimicking the split save. We can then drop into the split save by moving the knee that's on the floor, move the leg just outside, and then just sitting down onto your bum. Do so slowly because this will hit an increased stretch on your body. Once in a position, reach down. Again, focusing on bringing your chest down to your knees. If you can touch your toes, try and do so. If not, don't worry too much, because again, this will develop over time. And next, it's really important and often a muscle that's overlooked is your back. Go down on your knees and then reach forward and then stretch your back, and you'll be able to feel it if you push backwards. Do so with your palms flat on the ground and then turn your palms into the air. And this just changes the stretch ever so slightly and ensures more of the muscles are stretched and warm. This one, put both legs out in front of you and then bring your knee across. This is an excellent exercise for stretching the back of your leg at the top and all across your bum. Do so with the other leg. Try not to bounce any stretches. Instead, just focus on holding a stretch that you can feel. Never pull too much so that you feel pain, but make sure it's a nice and deep stretch. This one's called the 90-90, where the front leg is 90 degrees in front of you, and the back leg is also the same, 90 degrees behind you. Again, bring your chest down to the front of your body, to that knee. Don't worry about bringing the head so much, it's more the chest to get that deep stretch. Slowly bring both legs out, and then do the same on the other side, 90 degrees on the front and 90 degrees on the back, and then bring in your chest down to stretch. This time, bring both legs in front of you and then together, so the soles of your feet are touching, and with your elbow, gently push down against your knees, which stretches the groin area here. Press down, feel a deep stretch, but again, not too deep. Then put one leg out, keep the other leg against the inner thigh, and stretch in front of you. Do the same with the other leg. Touch your toes if you can, but I don't expect everyone to be able to do that. This is developed over time. I was actually fortunate enough to do karate when I was a child, therefore I've always been fortunate enough to be quite supple. The key to the next exercise is to lay flat on your back with your shoulders flat against the floor. Then put your arms outstretched and move your leg all the way across your body and try and touch your toe to the opposite hand. This stretches all of your back, your bum, even your leg. It's a really, really deep and satisfying stretch, and you'll feel perhaps muscles that you didn't even realize you have. Next, we're going to move on to the upper body, then the torso, the neck and the shoulders, all really important as a futsal goalkeeper. Start by having your legs just wider than shoulder width apart, reaching down the side of your body. Try not to lean forward or backwards on this one. Just keep your body nice and straight and just focus on going left or right. Then we bring our arms up across the body and just gently pull them towards us. You can feel the stretch on your shoulder. And rotate the shoulder forward and then backwards the other way. This helps just develop the range of motion that we'll be experiencing during a game, getting the shoulder muscle moving and ready for action. Next, we can introduce a futsal. This again helps get the shoulders moving by just passing the ball around you anti-clockwise first and then moving on to clockwise afterwards. The you can develop this by passing the futsal between your legs in a figure of eight. This took me a little while to get. If you keep practicing this, this is a nice little warm-up to introduce to your routine. And finally onto your neck muscles, looking one way, holding the look, then the other way, all the way up, and then all the way down. Finally, introduce a bit of pressure, push your neck muscles against one way, and then against the palm of your hand the other, then forward and backwards. Gently rotate the neck 180 degrees right, and then 180 degrees left.
And finally, we're going to do some goalkeeper specific warm-ups just to get us doing the right motions and getting us used to doing the things that we need to do in the game to make saves.
This exercise, I like to come out to a couple of cones just to mimic the block save that we'll make in a match. This shouldn't be done in anger. We're not trying to make the save here. We're just trying to move in the correct motions. So just coming out nice and slowly, going down on one knee and bringing your arms through as we should in a match.
So if you follow a similar routine to this, and I want to add, if you want to add anything to that, be sure to do so. If certain areas of your body are feeling tight or unprepared, spend more time stretching them. Get them ready so you feel ready to make the saves that you need to do in the match. There are plenty of other YouTube videos out there, guides about stretching, and feel free to experiment. There's lots of different techniques out there for different sports, but actually, a lot of them cross over really nicely with futsal goalkeeping. So things like athletics, handball goalkeeping especially, because those guys are incredibly flexible. Anything you can do or find, feel free to add it to your routine. And find something you're comfortable with. Find a routine that you're happy to do before the match. Don't do anything too exhausting, or don't do anything that's strenuous or hurts. And that brings me nicely on to injuries. If you're coming back from an injury and something's really painful, then truth of the matter is you probably should be resting. You probably shouldn't be playing yet. So make sure that you are fit and ready before going into any physical activity. Otherwise, there's a real chance you might make it worse. But other than that, this little drill that you can do by yourself really, really does help you get ready for the match. I think next steps would be maybe to ask some of your teammates, some strikers, to pop a few shots at you, just so you get used to the handling and the speed of the ball, because obviously that's essential for game time. But this will get you on your way and ready for the match.